In this first episode, I will quickly walk you through the setup needed for developing Flutter applications. Let's start with the Flutter web page. The docs are great. You just go to get started. You select your system. I'm using macOS. And there is a list of steps you need to perform. The first one is to get the Flutter SDK, the most important part. And you need to put it somewhere on your system. I've put it mine on code SDK. You can put it wherever you want. And then you just need to add it to your path. So depending on your shell, you just need to add it, and this way the Flutter command will be available anywhere, from anywhere. Once it's done, you can run Flutter Doctor to see which other dependencies are missing. So in my case, I've already completed all of them, but if you are starting, there'll be instructions, what needs to be installed, etc. So the next step is to perform a platform setup. So you can do both, so iOS and Android, or just one. So for iOS, it's pretty straightforward. You just need to install the command line tools, set up the emulator, then install some dependencies along with the package manager, and create a provisioning profile. For Android, is similar. So Flutter relies on a full installation of Android Studio, which is a bit funny because you need to install one editor to do, even if you don't use Android Studio. But I believe it's because it's just simpler. And so you just need to go to the website and fetch the Android Studio. Once it's done, there is a nice feature there, which is the Android Virtual Device Manager, which allows you to... So once you start it, you just create a project or select the one you already created, a dummy project, and then you go to... Let's close this one. You go to this option here, and here you can create your virtual devices. So you select which model you want to use. Then you select an image. I've created my emulator using an older version, but you should probably just stick to the recommended one. You need to download first and then select it. And then you just give it a name and click finish to create it. So once it's created, you can run your emulator from this window, or you can use your editor to launch it. I will show it in the next episode. So that's pretty much it. Once it's done, you can run again Flutter Doctor to see if you completed them correctly. This is a very handy, very cool little tool that comes with Flutter. So the final piece is to set up your editor. So you can stick with Android Studio, or you can use VS Code. I will be using VS Code in this tutorial. So there are just two elements to do. Two steps to do in VS Code. The first one is to install the two plugins. The first one is Flutter from Dart Code, and the second one is to install the Dart Code plugin, and that's pretty much it. So we will start creating our first application in the next episode. Stay tuned.